Alright guys, no? So good morning everyone. Okay, good morning po. Good morning sa lahat, no? So happy new year everyone. So it's the third day of 2024. So let's start the year guys, no, with a new lesson, no. Okay, sa ECE Essentials still under electromagnetic field theory. So for today, no, we'll be having antenna theory. Okay, lecture 4, antenna theory. Antenna parameters, fundamental types, and characteristics. Okay, so good morning sa lahat guys. Good morning. Okay, ayan, no. So we'll be actually this is the continuation, no, of the lecture. Okay, last year, ayan, no? So parang ang tagal, eh, no? Last year pa, eh, no? So, lesson natin last year, which is the wave propagation. Okay? So, this completes it. Okay, no? So, good morning, everyone, no? Ayan, no? So, as always, no? Like the session, guys, to mark your attendance. And let's start the session po. Okay? Sige. So, antenna. Okay? So, antenna. So, we will be studying antenna for today. Ayan. So, ano ba yung antenna? So, antenna basically, okay, this refers to an electrical conductor or array of conductors, no, that radiates signal energy or collects signal energy. So, kung mararecall nyo guys, no, ayan, meron tayong illustration dito. So, kindly refer to the illustration. So, we have the source. Okay, so we have our source, guys. Meron tayong source, no? And then, yung source natin is connected to what we call as the transmission line. So, connected siya sa transmission line, guys. Okay? So, yung source connected sa transmission line. And eventually, no, di ba, ang goal natin is wireless communication. So, we will utilize, no, the wave propagation. But what bridges? Okay, what bridges? Okay, no, so, di ba, this is the source. So, let me write, no. Ito yung source natin. So, this is the source. Okay, this is the transmission line. TX line. And this is the free space, no? Or, shall we say, the wireless communication. So, what bridge, no? The wireless communication and the transmission line, ito yung tinatawag nating antenna. Okay? So, antenna is technically a transducer, okay, that converts, no, electrical energy into radio wave or vice versa. Okay? Ayan. So, there are two things that you need to remember when it comes to antenna. Ano yung dalawang, ano na yun, no? Ano yung dalawang bagay na dapat nating tandaan, no, when it comes to antenna? So, number one, okay? So, number one, guys, no, ang antenna natin, guys, unang-una is reciprocal. Okay? Ano ibig sabihin ng reciprocal? So, reciprocal ang mga antenna, ha? So, ano ibig sabihin ng reciprocal? So, dito papasok yung antenna reciprocity or principle of reciprocity. So, it states that the antenna, okay, design, characteristics, and parameters ay the same, no? Whether you use it as a transmitting or receiving antenna. Okay? So, reciprocal ang mga antenna, guys. So, kung meron ka antenna na receiver, no, or for reception, you can also use that very same antenna for transmission, no? So hindi magkaiba yung design, no? Not unlike, for example, transmitter and receiver, magkaiba yung design nun, right? As in yung transmitter na device and the receiver na device, magkaiba yung design nila because they are intended for different purposes. However guys, no, yung antenna, natandaan, ito ay reciprocal. It can be used either, ano guys, it can be used either as a transmitting antenna or receiving antenna, yung design, parameters, characteristics, and everything will remain the same. Next, ano yung second na tatandaan pagdating sa antenna? Okay, although guys, no, today, no, so due to the development of technology, meron na tayong mga active antennas. But basically, yung mga traditional antenna in a sense, so these are passive devices. Okay? So passive devices, no? Yan. Pero sabi ko nga, no, nowadays, no, meron na tayong mga ano, no, meron na tayong mga active antennas, no, especially yung mga MIMO, no, yung multiple input multiple output, they have the beam forming capabilities na, no. Yan. But when we talk about the basic antennas, no, as we can see on the slides, ayan, no, so passive devices sila, so meaning wala siyang gain. Okay, wala siyang gain. Pag sinabing passive device, walang gain, no. Not unlike, 'di ba, amplifiers. Okay, so they add something, no, to the signal. Yung antenna, hindi ganun. Pero later on, we will talk about the antenna gain. So, ano yung gain ng antenna na yun? We will talk about it later. Okay? Ano yung gain pagdating sa concept ng antenna? It's not the same as the gain that the amplifiers introduce. Okay? Iba yung gain pagdating sa antenna. Alright? So, ito yung tatlong typical classification ng antennas na meron tayo. So, yung una, okay, we call this as the wire antennas. So, by the name itself, wire, it's made of wires. Yung mga wire antenna. So, ito yung mga dipole, helical antenna, yung mga loop antennas. Okay? Meron man tayong mga tinatawag na aperture antennas. Aperture is yung may, ano, may parang design na enclosure, like horn antenna. Yan, cone antenna. Yan, mga aperture antenna siya. Ngayon, ito naman, yung pangatlo is yung mga, ano, mga microstrip antennas. Okay, mga microstrip antenna. So, example ng microstrip antenna is the patch antenna. Okay, so ito, patch antenna yan. Yan yung mga antenna na maliliit, guys. No? So, yung mga mobile phones natin, yan, usually patch antenna yung ginagamit dyan. Okay? So, yan yung mga basic antennas na meron tayo. And of course, yung nabanggit natin na mga new or modern type antennas, no? Yung mga active na. Okay? Ayan, no? So, basta ang pinaka-basic concept, guys, tatandaan is the antenna is reciprocal and passive. Alright. So, next. Okay? So, in the context ng ECE board exam naman, no? So, ang focus natin is yung ano, guys, yung mga fundamental parameters ng antenna. So, marami iisa-isahin po natin. So, number one na importante, no, pagdating sa antenna is what we call as the radiation pattern. Okay? The radiation pattern. So, ano yung radiation pattern? So, when we say radiation pattern pagdating sa antenna, so this refers to the mathematical function or graphical representation ng radiation properties, no, ng antenna. Okay? So, basically, parang graph siya. Okay? Na makikita natin, no? So, for example, this is the antenna. Okay, ito yung antenna natin. So, this is the, for example, this is your dipole antenna, right, guys? So, teka ha, kita ba? So, medyo i-shade natin, no? So, let's say, guys, ito yung antenna natin, no? Yan yung kulay violet, guys. So, this is your antenna po. Okay? Yung kulay violet, kung nakikita. Okay, hopefully. Pero medyo malabo yata. So, anyway, so, ngayon, yung antenna natin, nag-radiate ng, ano, di ba? Nag-radiate siya ng signal, right? So, radio wave. So, ito yung itsura ng radio wave niya, no? Kapag ka tinignan natin. Okay? So, ganyan yung itsura niya. Diba? You have the antenna and then magra-radiate siya ng radio wave in this manner. Okay? So, ang tawag doon is the radiation pattern. So, ngayon, yung antenna natin, no? So, pa nag-radiate siya ng signal, meron tayong mga tinatawag na region. No? As you can see here. So, meron tayong tinatawag na near field reactive region. We also have the Fresnel region, radiating near field region. And radiating near field region, and we also have the far field region. So far field region tayo, guys, no, kapag ka magta-transmit. Okay, so we need to ensure, guys, that yung sesendan natin, no, ng signal is in the far field region. Okay, so kailangan nasa far field siya para fully established na, no, yung ating radio wave pagdating doon. So yun, no? So yun yung mga region, 'di ba? You have the antenna na yung pinakagitna, no, ito yung antenna mo. So yung unang part niya, ang tawag doon is the near field reactive region. Then after that, we have the near field pero radiating region na siya. And then eventually yung ginagamit natin, which is the far field region. And as I mentioned, guys, no, we need to ensure, guys, that ito, no. Oh, by the way, guys, no, ito yung formula for the far field. So beyond R2, okay, we can say that we are already in the far field. Nagets, guys? So, ito, no? Actually, ito, dito masyadong natatanong, guys. Pero, I've given this just in case. So, mas madalas, guys, na natatanong is about the far field. So, let us answer a question, no, with regards sa far field. So, beyond what distance from the antenna operating at 8 megahertz is considered to be far field? No? So, antenna diameter is 8 meters. Okay? Okay, solve po natin, guys, yung question. What will be the solution? So, let us solve, no? Let us solve the problem. So, gusto nating malaman, no, beyond which distance daw, mako-consider natin na far field na tayo. So, R2 yung hinahanap, guys, no, kasi far field. So, the equation for R2, so we have 2D square over lambda. 2D square over lambda. Okay, so diameter natin is 8 meters, guys. So 2, okay, times 8 square, yeah, no, over the wavelength. Okay, no, so wavelength natin, no, so of course, that is 3 times 10 to the 8, okay, over the frequency, no, which is, in this case, is 8 megahertz. 8 times 10 to the 6. Okay, guys, so come on, help me. What will be the R2? So ano yung parang far field region natin? So help me solve the question, guys. So we have 2d square over 3 to the 8 over 8 to the 6. So we have 3.41 meters. Okay, so ibig sabihin, guys, no, paglagpas ng 3.41 meters, no, so far field na tayo. Yan. Okay, option C, very good, no? Yan. Very good, Jones. Yan, Alexis, very good, no? Kirsten, very good. Option C, everyone, is the correct answer. Okay, next is, okay, no? So, ang coordinate system, no? So, yan, ha? We will go back. Although, ano, no? Inuna kasi natin yung mga, ano, no? Advanced na part ng EMFT. Pero one of the basic parts ng EMFT, okay, is the coordinate system. So, have you ever wondered, no, why are, ano, no, during your subject na electromagnetics, no, so pinag-aralan nyo yung tinatawag na, ano, na spherical coordinate system. Okay, tapos hindi nyo na siya ginamit ever since, di ba? Yan, so actually, no, sa ECE, very important, no, yung spherical coordinate system because the antenna, okay, the antenna is analyzed, no, on the spherical coordinate system. Okay? So, spherical coordinate system po yung antenna because, okay, the antenna, ang idea is yung pinaka-basic antenna, yung pinaka-pangit na antenna is radiating, no, equally in all directions. Okay? So, yun ha, tandaan ha. When I was in college before, no, I thought that the good antenna is the one that radiates equally in all directions. But that is wrong, ha? That is the worst case na antenna, no, yung pinakapangit na antenna yon. Yung antenna na mag-radiate equally in all directions. Because remember, okay, we want the antenna to be directional. Directional. So, dapat isang direction lang siya as much as possible. Okay? So, at any rate, no, so yun nga, no, as you can see, no, ito yung example, no, kita nyo yung drawing. So, yung antenna natin, okay, is analyzed on the spherical coordinate system. Now, for example, no, magpapadala tayo ng beam, okay, because the signal in the antenna is sent into a beam-like fashion. So, let's say, ito yung beam natin, di ba? So, ngayon yung beam natin, no, so, yung surface ngayon niya, o, syempre, pag may beam ka, no, ang magiging surface mo is, kasi spherical, so circular yan, no? Yan, no? Circular section yung makukuha natin. Kumbaga, ang shape na makukuha na, ang shape na ma-form natin, okay, as a whole, is a cone. So, cone is a 3D figure. So, yung angle dito is not just simply degrees. So, yung angle natin dito, yung tinatawag nating, ano, omega. So, yung omega natin, this is a solid angle. Okay, angle subtended not by a triangle, 'di ba? Usually kapag angle parang mukhang triangle 'yon. So ito by a cone. Okay? So we call this as what? Okay, we call this solid angle as steradian. Okay? I mean, that's the measure of the solid angle, parang radian. Kapag normal na angle radian, kapag solid angle we have steradians. So ito siya, omega siya, no, instead of theta. Okay? So, ngayon guys, no, so sabi ko nga, spherical coordinate system yan. So, if you want to find the angle in steradian, you just need to take the integral of this function. So, yung sine ng theta d phi. Okay? So, integral lang natin yan. Para makuha natin or ma-measure natin yung solid angle in steradians. So, again guys, ha, diba, kaya rin antenna mo, yung beam niya, okay, may angle yung beam na yun, diba? So, yung angle na yun is measured in solid angle in this particular case. Okay, don't be confused mamaya because we will be talking about beamwidth. So, yung beamwidth guys, this is in the radiation pattern kasi. Okay, ha? So, baka malito kayo eh. Yung angle talaga ng antenna is in steradian, which is the solid angle. Pero when we talk about the beamwidth later, that is also an angle, yung beamwidth na yun is measured with respect to the radiation pattern. And if we go back, the radiation pattern is 2D. Okay, radiation pattern is 2D. But the actual antenna is 3D. Okay, 3 dimension. Null. Okay? So anyway, let's answer a question, guys. Yeah, no? So for a sphere of radius r, find the solid angle omega, okay, instant radians of a spherical cap on the surface of the sphere over the north pole region defined by the spherical angles 0 degrees to 30 degrees and 0 degrees to 360 degrees. Okay? So what will be the solution? So by the way, guys, no, with regards to the calculations, numerical calculations, sometimes hindi saktong-sakto yung sagot, no? So if that's the case, we will just select the nearest answer. Okay? Kasi ano yun, no? Very traditional yung ating examiner pagdating sa subject na ito, yung topic na ito. So very traditional siya. So when I say traditional, minsan yung calculation na ginagamit niya is maraming mga rounding off discrepancies. Kasi tayo sanay na tayo sa paggamit ng scientific calculator natin na dire-diretso lang eh. Okay, pero nung kinraft yung mga questions dito, okay, medyo rounding off ng rounding off yung nangyayari, kaya medyo malayo ng konti sa correct answer, pero discernible naman. Anyway, I will show you here, no? So, this is simple, right? We just need to solve for theta. So, omega. So, yung omega is simply equal sa double integral. Double integral ng ano? Ng sine theta, okay, d theta, sine theta, d phi. Okay? So, ano limit, guys, nung theta? So, yung theta daw is from 0 to 30 degrees. So, 0 hanggang pi. Kasi, di ba, pi over 6. Pi over 6 yung 30 degrees, right? Yan, pi over 6 yan. Tapos, yung isa naman is from 0 to 360 degrees. So, that is 0 to 2 pi. 0 to 2 pi. Okay, no? So, usually, ang integral pagka ganito, we can easily distribute, kasi constants yung limits of integration. So, we can just separate them. So, yung una, integral ng 0 to 2 pi. Okay, tapos d phi. Okay, yan yung partner niya. Sa double integral, guys, it works like parenthesis. Ito yung magka-partner po. Yung outside integrals, ito yung magka-partner. Okay, and the inner integrals, no? Ito yung magka-partner. Okay, guys? So, sana nagets, no? Yan yung magka-partner. So, bale, we will have another integral here. So, ito naman, this is sine theta. Okay, sine theta d theta from 0 to pi over 6. Because pi over 6, again, is 30 degrees. Okay, so we perform the integral, guys. So, anong makukuha natin, no? Pi over 5 na type ko, no? Pi over 6. Yan. So, what will be our solid angle? Right. So, ang lalabas, guys, ay 0.842. Ayan, no? 0.842 steradian. Okay? So, this is the answer. Ayan, di ba? Wala doon sa choices, no? Pero ano yung pinaka-nearest answer? So, it happens, no? Especially in this subject, guys. Okay? So, dapat, familiar kayo doon. No? So, what is the nearest? If 842 yung lalabas, so the nearest is 835. Okay? 835 is the nearest. So, this is the answer. Okay? So, option D is the answer. So, anong nangyari dyan? If you want to get the exact 0.835, ang ginawa ng examiner is, kinuha niya muna yung integral nito. So, ang lalabas kasi dito ay 0.134, I think. Ayan, yun yung minultiply niya. Bali, 0.134 times 2 pi. 0.133 ginagawa niya. Ayan, 0.133. Okay, so the examiner make this 0.133. 0.133 times 2 pi, 0.835 lalabas. Ayan, try nyo, guys. No? ganun yung nangyari, no? Nung calculation ng examiner. Sabi ko nga, no, the examiner is traditional engineer. So, yung mga engineer kasi nun, di ba? Parang, I don't know kung inabot nyo pa yun, no? Meron mga, may mga trigonometric tables pa na ginagamit in calculation. So, kaya ganun yung naging answer, no? Wala sila yung parang calculator natin na diretso na ilalabas na answer. Okay? So, anyway, so sana nagets po, no? Alright. So, next natin is the radiated power. So, sabi ko nga, no, the main job of the antenna is to convert, no, from electrical current nagaling sa transmission line papuntang radio wave, no, or the uniform plane wave or the transverse electromagnetic wave or vice versa. So of course guys, no, we have the formula for the radiated power, and the radiated power is simply the dot product, no, the surface integral ng dot product nung W average tsaka yung DS. Okay, sir, ano yung DS, guys? Ay, sir, so yung DS po, okay, ano ba yung radial component, no, sa electromagnetics to? So ito yung R square, okay, sine theta, D theta, D phi, AR. Yan, oh. So yan yung formula natin for D, DS. Ngayon, sir, ano tong W average? So ito yung tinatawag nating ano, average value ng pointing vector. Yan, oh. So we have the average value of pointing vector. Okay, pointing vector. So yung pointing vector, guys, no, is this is actually just simply the cross product ng E and H. As you can see here, no? So ayan, cross product siya nung ano, no? Cross product siya nung by the way, no, this is in the radial direction. So kaya ang nangyari pag cross product, mawawala lang yung dalawang AR. So this is the real part ng cross product ng E and H. Okay? So this is the average value, no, ng pointing vector. Actually, as you can see, di ba, kung nare-recall nyo in the previous lesson, pag minultiply mo yung E and H, okay, what you're gonna get here actually is the power density. So, this is actually the average power density. Okay, no? So, it's similar to the power density, the average power density. Okay? So, ganun guys. No? So, yun yung mga terminologies natin, ha? So, yung W average, this is the average value ng pointing vector. Pointing vector is basically the cross product ng electric field component and the magnetic field component ng ating uniform plane wave. So basically, when we say pointing vector, this is a vector quantity that gives the magnitude and direction ng power density, okay? Or the power, no, ng isang uniform plane wave. Okay? So yan. Ngayon, okay, no? Usually kasi, okay, electric field component ang nakukuha. So, pag sinolve natin yung cross product niya, tapos kinuha natin yung real part, so this actually simplifies to this one. So, yung W average natin, no, as a vector is simply the magnitude of E, okay, square over 2 times D. Okay, kasi may 1 half eh, kaya may over 2. Intrinsic characteristic impedance. And if this is vector quantity, this is AR. No? So, kung hindi naman siya vector quantity, alisin mo lang yung AR, yun pa din yung magnitude niya. So, if we just get the magnitude of the W average. Okay? Ayan, so, usually, ito, ginagamit natin yan. Actually, madalas sa calculations natin later, ito yung gagamitin. Okay? So, please remember this one. This formula. Kesa dun sa may cross product. Okay? Sige, ha? So, let's try to answer a question, no? Ayan. A hypothetical isotropic antenna, okay, radiating in free space. Okay, at a distance of 100 meters from the antenna, the total electric field E is measured to be 5 volts per meter. Solve for the power radiated by the antenna. Okay? So, what will be the solution, guys? What will be the solution? Okay. Tapos, ano tong term na isotropic antenna? So, isotropic antenna, guys, as I mentioned kanina, ito yung ano, no, pinakapangat na antenna, guys. Kumbaga, ano, no, usually yung mga comparison natin with regards sa antenna, we always compare this to the isotropic antenna. Kasi siya yung pinaka-basis, no, dahil ito yung pinakapangit. Kumbaga, when you are checking if yung performance ng antenna mo ay maganda, check mo gano'n siya kalaki compared sa isotropic. Okay? So, when we say isotropic antenna, so, basically, this is a point, a hypothetical antenna, and the idea is that it will radiate power equally in all directions. So, spherical, basically, no? Yung kanyang transmission or propagation ng ano, radio wave. Okay? Yan. So, tatandaan yan, ha? Okay. Anyway, ano bang pinapasolve sa atin? We are asked to solve for the radiated power. So, yung P-rad, okay, ano yung formula niya? Sabi rito is the surface integral. Okay, so double integral yon pag surface integral, right? So double integral ng ano guys? Ng W average, okay? Yan, multiplied by D, ano? W average multiplied by DS. Which is, ano ba yung DS natin? So that is R square, okay, sine theta, okay, D theta, okay, D phi. D phi. Now guys, you don't need to perform the integral po, no? Okay, pag sinabing isotropic. Bakit? Kasi pag sinabing isotropic, fix po yung limits natin na 0 to pi, tsaka 0 to pi over 0 to 2 pi. Ayan, so again, ha, these are the limits kung isotropic. So kung isotropic lang yan, ha, isotropic. So hindi mo na kailangan mag-compute guys, no, pag isotropic siya. Bakit? Kasi since yung limits niya ay constant, yung result is always the same. So for isotropic antenna, yung mangyayari is radiated power. Yung integral na yan, yung buong integral na yan, 4 pi r square lang mangyayari dyan. Okay, again, this is only true for isotropic. 4 pi r square W ave, okay, all over, oh, wala na, yun na pala. Wala na palang over. Okay? So, sulat natin, no? So, quantity, 4 pi r square, okay, W, point, average ng pointing vector. Okay? So, naintindihan po. So, this is again, ha, for isotropic lang, ha? Hindi mo na kailangan mag-integral dahil sabi ko nga, ang limits will always be the same. So, the result of the integral will always be the same also. So, na-compute na siya, no? Pag isotropic, 4 pi r square lagi. Okay? Gets? Gets? Now, electric field ang given sa atin. So, we will change the W ab into what? So, we have quantity 4 pi r square. Okay, multiplied by, ano yung W ab natin? We have mod of E square over, okay, 2 intrinsic impedance, no? So, yan yung magiging formula. Okay, no? So, ibig sabihin guys, no? So, continuing. So, we have what? Okay, we have, you know, so we have the P-rad. So, ano yung magiging P-rad natin, guys? So, we have 4 pi r square. So, what is the distance? Ano yung distance natin? Sabi sa problem is 100 meters. So, 100 square lang po. Okay, multiplied by. Okay, so ano yung ating magnitude, no? So, given naman 5. So, this is simply 5 square over 2 times. Okay, ano yung intrinsic characteristic impedance ng free space? So, 120 pi. Okay, 120 pi. So, pagdating sa antenna, no, usually mga problems natin is ano, no, free space siya. Okay? So, what will be the P-rad, guys? Okay, the radiated power. So, very good, no? Ayan, crystalline is given by 41. Okay, 66.67 watts. Okay, option C is the answer. Okay, option C is the answer. Okay, clear? And Jemima Francis, very good, no? So, option C is the answer. Clifford, very good, no? Okay. So, naintindihan po? Ayun, no? So, bali, fix na yan, guys, no? Kapag ka, ano, for isotropic, no? So, let me write, okay, the equation again. So, para, ito na lagi yung gagamitin nyo, no? Hindi na kayo magde-derive-derive pa na ganyan. So, for isotropic antenna, pag hindi na isotropic, tuturo ko mamaya yung gagawin, ha? Iba yung ginagawa pang hindi na isotropic, eh. So, for isotropic antenna, the radiated power, okay, will always be equal sa, okay, will always be equal sa 4 pi r square, yan, multiplied by e square over 2 eta. Okay? So, laging ganyan yung formula. Okay, now guys, let's talk about the radiation intensity. So, what is radiation intensity U? Okay? So, what is the radiation intensity U? So, radiation intensity, okay, in a given direction is defined as the power radiated from the antenna per solid angle. Okay? So, from the standard result, no, of the radiated power, actually, so ito guys, yan, this quantity, no, kasi diba, the calculation of power, radiated power, is simply equal sa surface integral ng dot product ng average ng pointing vector and the ds. Okay? And ds is given as, okay, so r square sine theta d theta d phi. Okay, AR, no? So, ito sa AR. Yan, yan natin nalagay. So, may AR dyan. Okay, ngayon guys, ito po, yan, itong quantity na ito, this one, okay, yung W of R square, pwede natin siyang i-represent as a single quantity and that is the radiation intensity. So, this is the U. Okay, yan yung magiging U natin. So, U is the radiation intensity. So, U po, capital letter U, no, yung symbol natin. Okay? So, sabihin, magiging U. Tapos, di ba, itong sin theta, d theta, d phi, this is the, kung nare-recall nyo kanina, yan yung angle insteradian. So, this is d omega. Okay, no? So, this is d omega. So, ibig sabihin, guys, no, yung radiated power is simply equal sa integral, okay, surface integral ng, ano, ng U d omega. Yan, no? So, kung na-recall nyo sa lesson natin kanina. Okay? Yan. So, again, ha? Tatandaan, ha? So, one important formula here is that the U is equal simply sa R square and the average value of the pointing vector. So, this is what we call as the radiation intensity. Ano lang siya? Another way of representing, no? Okay, the parameters, no, ng antenna. Okay, so let's have this one. Yan, kagaya nito, di ba? We are asked to solve for the radiated power, pero we are given with the radiation intensity. So, given the radiation intensity of the antenna, 5 sine theta, so calculate the radiated power for 0 to 90 degrees and 0 to 360 degrees. Okay, so solve natin. So, this result, this is not a standard result, guys. Yeah, no, kasi kung standard result hindi na tayo mag-aano eh, no? Hindi na tayo mag i-integral kasi kapag isotropic ang solid angle ay 4 pi. Okay? Kaya lang hindi siya isotropic eh. Paano niyo nalaman na hindi isotropic, sir? Kasi pagka isotropic ang angle supposed to be is 0 to 180 at 0 to 360. Gets? So again, ha, so sulat ko muna 'yung special result, no? So for isotropic antenna, yan. So, for isotropic antenna, so kung isotropic antenna tayo, guys, okay, ang angle natin ay 0, theta, 180 degrees, okay, 0, okay, phi, 360 degrees. So, for isotropic antenna, guys, okay, angle natin is simply equal sa 4 pi. Okay? Yun na yun, no? Ayan. Solid angle natin ay equal sa 4 pi. Okay? So, that's it. Okay? So, 4 pi lang. Multiply nyo lang dun kay 5 sine theta. Hindi mo na kailangan mag-integral, guys. Alright? So, kaya lang, in this particular problem, okay, hindi tayo isotropic, so we will perform integral. Hindi, actually, mag-perform ka na integral kahit isotropic eh, kasi may sine theta ka rito eh, no? Okay, so, yeah. I mean, kapag mga constants lang yung given. Anyway, so, game, no? Perform tayo ng integral. So, what is period, guys? So, period, okay, is simply equal sa, ano yung una integral natin? So, yung una integral natin ay 0 to 90. So, that is 0 to pi over 2. Okay, yung pangalawang integral natin. Ah, teka. Yan. So, sa loob ko ilagay, no? So, ito yung 0 to pi over 2. So, this is the first integral. Pangalawa ay 0 to 2 pi. 0 to 2 pi, ayan yung 0 to 360. So, radiation intensity is 5. Okay, sine theta. And kung nare-recall nyo, no, ano yung d omega natin for the solid angle? So, that is simply equal sa sine theta. Okay? Sine theta, d theta, DV. Okay? Nagets po? Okay. So, ang evaluation niyan, guys, okay, so, ano siya, no? Pwede mo pag-iwalayin, no? Because the limits are constants, so you can actually separate them. So, pwede natin siyang pag-iwalayin, guys. Ay. And we can actually separate the integral. So, bale, ang mangyayari is P rad is equal sa yung integral natin, 0 to 2 pi ng dV multiplied sa integral ng 0 to pi ng 5 sine square d theta. Okay, so what will be the result, guys? What will be the result po? So, integral ng sine square from 0 to pi multiplied by 2 pi. So, we'll be getting what? 49? Oh, teka. Yeah, no. Pi over 2 pala. Sorry guys, no, supposed to be pi over 2. Okay? Pi over 2. Okay? Pi over 2 ha. Sorry, nagkamali tayo ng lagay kanina. Pi over 2 po. So, we have 24.67. Okay? So, we have 24.67 watts. So, option A is the answer. Okay. Very good, no? Very good, everyone. 24.67. So, malinaw, guys. Nagets na po. Okay. So, ganun lang, ha? Ganun lang. Okay. Sige. Next. Ayan, no? So, ito yung na-mention ko kanina, no? Beam width. Beamwidth is also angle. Okay? Beamwidth is also angle. So, beamwidth of a radiation pattern is defined as the angular separation between two identical points, okay, on opposite sides of opposite side of the pattern maximum. Okay, guys, no? So, ngayon, pag walang ibang sinabi, we are actually talking about what we call as the half power beamwidth. We are actually talking about what we call as the half power beamwidth. Okay, we are talking about the half power beamwidth. So, nagets guys? All right. So, ano yung ano no, half power beamwidth? Half power beamwidth, okay? Ito po yung ano no, tawag dito. Ito po yung part ng radiation pattern kung saan nagkaroon tayo ng 3 dB drop. Okay, so let's say guys, no, that this is the ano no, this is the maximum. Kunyari, look at the radiation pattern, guys, no. So let's say guys that this portion is the maximum. Okay, maximum radiation. So ito yung 0 degrees, no. Yan. Ito yung parang preferred direction natin, 0 degrees. Okay, maximum direction. Maximum radiation. Okay. Yan, actually 90 degrees, no? Yan, 90 degrees kung ito kung nasa taas yung 0 natin, so 90 degrees. Okay? So, ngayon guys, yan. Kasi pag 0 degrees saktong-sakto dapat na nandiyan eh. I mean, isang direction lang eh. Kaya ang ginagawa natin range. So, ibig sabihin, no? So, hinahanap natin yung point kung saan ang power natin is minus 3 dB. Kasi ito yung maximum eh. Sa kabilang side din, hinahanap natin ano yung minus 3 dB. Dinuduktong natin sa origin. Okay, dinuduktong natin sa origin. So, ngayon, yung range na yon, okay, kapag nasa loob nito, yun, nasa loob nung beam na yan, okay, ito yung ano natin, no, area kung saan, ano, no, sinasabi natin na satisfactory yung reception and transmission natin sa antenna. Okay, nagets? Yung may shaded na pink, guys. Ayan, no? So, ayan po yun. So, malinaw po. Naintindihan? Okay. Ayan, no? So, yun yung tinatawag na beamwidth, no? So, yung range, okay, kung saan yung ano natin, no? 1/2. Okay? In a plane containing the direction of the maximum propagation ng beam, the angle between the two directions in which the radiation intensity is one half of the beam. Okay? So, minus 3 dB. Kumbaga, ano eh, no? Yun yung acceptable, no? Acceptable sa atin. Okay? Kaya usually, no, pag sinabing beam width, we are talking about the half power beam width. Okay? So, kukunin mo yung ano, no, sa radiation pattern, asa yung minus 3 dB, sa kabilang side, asan yung minus 3 dB. So, yung range na yun, okay, yun yung ibig sabihin, within that, dun tayo mag, ano, no, yun yung direction, no, kung saan satisfactory yung ating transmission and reception. Okay. So, let's answer a question now, guys. So, a normalized radiation intensity of antenna is given by, no, ito yung formula ng U natin. Okay, so this is the formula for the U, guys. Ayan. Okay, the radiation intensity. Okay, determine the half power beam width. So, bale, ano yun eh, theta yung sinasolve natin, no? So, pag theta, guys, no, so this is 90 degrees, no? So, let me correct this, ha? Kasi theta to. So, dapat 90 siya. Kasi pag theta, guys, okay, ang zero is yung nandito. Yung nasa taas. Okay, yun ang zero. No? So, don't be confused, ha? Kapag theta yung sinasolve natin, co-latitude kasi yun, no, yung theta. Yan, ito yung 0 degrees. So, ito yung 90. Okay, anyway. So, theta yung hinahanap natin dito. This is, we are asked to solve for the half power beam width. Kaya lang, mahirap isolve yung angle, guys, even if you have your calculator. Oh, kasi ano siya yung angle eh. So, the angle can give you many answers. So, ang suggestion ko sa inyo, guys, okay, my suggestion is you just select from the choices. Tapos, isubstitute nyo doon sa radiation intensity. That will be the solution. Dahil may choices naman, no? Especially sa board exam, may choices naman. So, ang gagawin natin, guys, is you just select from the choices and we substitute, no? And you calculate the U. So, ito yung expression natin for U, guys, right? So, the expression for U is given as, okay, we have cosine square theta. We have cosine square theta. Okay, and then cosine square 3 theta. So, cosine square 3 theta. Cosine square 3 theta. Okay, no? So, paano natin malalaman yung half power beam width, guys? So, we will just select from the choices and we will substitute sa theta. However, dahil beam width tong mga to, guys, remember that the beam width, kasi yung theta mo, ito lang eh. Okay? The theta here is ito lang. So, this is also theta, guys. So, in other words, no, the beam width is 2 times theta. So, i-divide nyo by 2 before you substitute. I-divide nyo by 2 before you substitute. So, halimbawa, try natin yung option A. So, try natin yung A. So, try natin yung A. So, yung A kasi nakalagay 28.75 degrees. So, pag sinubstitute natin, ano yung theta dyan? Yung kalahati po nito. Ano ba kalahati ng 28.75 degrees? So, 28.75 over 2. So, we get okay, 14.375. So, 14.375 degrees. Ito yung theta. Kasi twice eh, para makuha yung beam width. So, yun yung isa-substitute natin. So, try natin isubstitute yan. So, anong makukuha? Bali, cosine ng square and cosine ng 3x square. Calc natin si 14.375. Okay, make sure na naka-degrees na yung calc yun yun, no? So, okay. So, kita nyo guys, no? Pag sinubstitute natin, so, ano magiging value ng U natin? So, yung U natin equals cosine square ng 14.375. Okay, and then we have cosine square again ng 3 times ng 14.375. Okay, so what will be the result sa U, guys? So, the result sa U is approximately what? Approximately 1 half. Okay? So, dahil approximately 1 half siya, in other words, no, this is the half power beam width. Okay? That is the half power beam width. So, naiintindihan, guys? Nagets po? Yan. Clear? Clear? Okay. Yan. Approximately 1/2. No, hanapin nyo ano yung 1/2. Kaya lang, ang caveat dito, dapat di-divide nyo by 2 yung choices. Because the half power beam width is actually twice nung, ano, co-latitude. Okay? So that's the concept there. That's the concept there. Okay? All right. Next, ayan. No, so as we mentioned kanina, no, during the first part nung lesson, is that the antenna is passive, no? Yung mga traditional antenna natin, mga passive devices sila. But pero okay, meron siyang gain. And we call this gain specifically to be the directive gain. And later on, no, meron din tayong gain lang talaga, the antenna gain, but basically the antenna gain is just simply the directive gain defined in another sense. So ano ba yung directive gain? So directive gain, sometimes called as directivity also, so refers to the ratio of the radiation intensity in a given direction from the antenna to the radiation intensity average over all directions. Average over all directions. So, anong ibig sabihin nun, guys? Okay. Ayan, no? So, yeah. Ayan. Sorry, medyo nawala. Okay. So, anyway. Teka, ha? Ayusin ko lang, ha? Alright. So, anong ibig sabihin nun? So, yung gain natin, no? Pagdating sa ano po? Sa antenna. Okay. It's not the same as the gain that we know, no, pagdating sa amplifiers. So yung gain natin dito is the directive gain. Okay? Meron tayong antenna gain mamaya, guys, but yung antenna gain again is simply just a revised definition of the directive gain. Basically, they are all about directivity or direction. Okay? So hindi siya kagaya ng amplifiers, no, na nag-a-add ng power or nag-a-add ng voltage, current, hindi ganun. So, ano ang gain? Ano ang directive gain pagdating sa antenna? So, ang analogy ko dito, no, sa students when I'm explaining this is yung ano, no? Are you familiar with the ano, with the funnel? Okay, funnel. Yung embudo, no, funnel. Are you familiar with that? Ayan. So, funnel. Okay, funnel, no? So, ang funnel, guys, okay, so it's, ano, no? It's a tool. Tool talaga, eh, no? Na ginagamit, guys, no, para magsaling tayo sa maliliit na container. So, halimbawa, no, bibili tayo ng, ano, no, suka. Na, dati kasi yung suka na bibili, ano, hindi pa yung nakapak, eh, no? So, bali, parang bibili ka, ano, no, ilalagay dun sa parang lalagyanan mo. So, ang hirap isaling, di ba? Mahirap isaling yun kapag wala kang funnel. Kasi, ano eh, maliit lang yung butas ng bote and then isasaling mo siya. So, maraming masasayang, right? Pag gumamit ka ngayon ng funnel, okay? So, instead, no, pag gumamit ka ng funnel is that all the liquid, no, in this case, yung suka, is mare-redirect doon sa bote natin. Okay, nagets, guys? So, when compared sa hindi gumamit ng funnel, so, hindi tayo gumamit ng funnel, guys. Ayan, no? So, versus, no? Okay, may funnel versus sa walang funnel. Okay, no? So, mahirap, ano, no? Mahirap i-shoot dun sa iyong container yung, ano? Mahirap i-shoot sa iyong container yung laman na gusto mong ilagay. Okay? So, mas marami kang mai-shoot pag gumamit ka ng funnel kaysa wala. That is the analogy pagdating sa antenna. So, pag gumamit ka ng antenna, no, okay, yung power natin ay may redirect natin in a single direction. Okay? Compared sa, okay, gagamit ka nung isotropic antenna na kalat-kalat siya or sabog-sabog because this is all over, all directions. Nagets? So, naintindihan na? So, yung pag-gain natin, guys, no, it's not the same as the gain ng amplifiers na nag-a-add ng power, voltage, or current. So, simply, no, when we say directive gain, is comparison na gagamit ka ng antenna to redirect the energy in a single direction, in a single point, compared sa isotropic na antenna na kalat-kalat or sabog-sabog because it is all over all the directions. Okay? Nagets, guys? Yes. So, now, sa calculation, no, it is simply equal, guys, saan? Okay. So, the maximum directivity, okay? Okay, the maximum directive gain. So, usually, sa maximum directive gain, ito yung tinatawag nilang directivity, no? Yan. Although, interchangeably sometimes, when in place ng directive gain, they use the word directivity. Okay? So, paiba-iba, guys, eh. Pero usually yan, yung maximum directive gain, that is directivity. So this is simply equal sa 4 pi U max over P rad. Okay, 4 pi U max over P rad. So yan yung calculation niya. Okay? Mamaya guys, no, when we say antenna gain, it's just the same as directive gain. Meron lang konting pagkakaiba sa definition. So, pero ganito pa rin yung formula niya, kaya tandaan yung formula nito. Alright? So, nagets guys? Okay, sige. So, let us solve a problem, no, with regards to this one. Yan. So, the radial component of the radiated power density of an infinitesimal linear dipole of length L is less than lambda is given by... Okay, no? So, the average ng pointing vector is sine square theta over r square ar, watts per square meter. So, determine the maximum directivity of the antenna. Okay, maximum directivity ng antenna is Dmax. So, basically, ito yung hinahanap, guys. Okay, Dmax. So, anong formula ng Dmax, guys? No? So, what will be the solution po? Okay, what will be the solution? Yan yung solution natin, no? So, anong formula ng Dmax po? So, Dmax is equal sa 4 pi ay times Umax, okay, over P rad. Okay? Ayan, no? So, 4 pi Umax over P rad. Okay? So, how do you get Umax, guys? So, yung Umax, okay, yun muna yung kunin natin una. Solve muna natin yung Umax, guys. So, how are we going to do that? Yun muna yung solve natin, no? So, for Umax, so, alam natin na yung U is equal sa R square, okay, W ave. So, yung U natin is equal sa R square times, ano yung W abe natin? So, we have AO, okay, sine square theta, all over R square. Kita natin na-cancel yung R square, guys. So, yung U natin is equal sa, okay, AO, sine square theta. AR. So from there, what do you think would be the value of the Umax? Okay? Kasi may sign siya na naka-multiply eh. No? So we can actually figure out ano yung maximum value, guys. So what is Umax po? So pag may sign, guys, tatandaan ang maximum value nun 1. Tama? Okay, maximum value niya is 1. So kung meron kang AO, okay, meron kang AO, yan, A o sine square theta. AR. So, yung maximum nito is 1. Diba? Kasi ang sine function, ang maximum value niya ay 1 eh. So, in other words, guys, no, yung Umax natin is equal sa 1. Okay? Okay, magnitude, no? So, kunyari, ignore natin yung vector quantity. So, magnitude. Yan, kasi magnitude lang naman yung kailangan natin, eh. Okay? So, this is equal sa A sub 0. Okay po? Okay, guys? Alright. Next. Okay, P-rad. How do we get the P-rad, guys? P-rad is simply the integral. Okay, no? So, P-rad. Yan, P-rad ay equal sa double integral. Okay. So, first is, ano po? Sine square theta. Yan. Kasi, di ba, yung P rad natin, kung nare-recall nyo pa, is W abe. Ano yung W abe natin? So, we have, di kasha, no? Teka. So, let me continue sa next slide, guys. Yan. Kasi hindi kasha, eh, no? So, tandaan nyo lang muna to, ha? Ito lang muna. So, let me insert another slide. Continuation lang to ng solution, ha? Continuation ng solution natin. So, for ano naman tayo? For period naman tayo. Period. Okay. So, ano equation natin for period, guys? So, period is simply equal sa double integral. Yan. So, pag walang sinabi, so, ang assumption na limits natin ay 0 to pi and 0 to 2 pi, ha? 0 to 2 pi. Okay? So, kailangan mag-integral tayo kasi may sine square na, merong a o sine square dito eh. So, a o sine square. Okay, a o sine square. Okay, over r square. And yung ds natin, ito yung w abe, right? Yung ar natin mawawala na kasi may ar din yung ds, no? So, o sige, lagay ko na lang ha, ar. Okay, multiplied by, ano yung ds natin? Ds natin is r square sine theta d theta d phi. Ar. Since pare silang may ar, that would cancel. Kasi ar times, that product ng ar tsaka ar is 1. Yan, r square would cancel. No? So, in other words, no, anong maiiwan sa integral natin? So, yung maiiwan sa integral natin is simply, what? So, bali, yung period natin would be, yung AO is constant, so ilabas ko na siya. So, una integral ay 0 to 2 pi d phi. So, yung pangalawa integral ay sine cube theta d theta from 0 to pi. Okay? So, what will be the result of the period, guys? So, what will be the result of the period? Okay? So, we have sine cube from 0 to pi times 2 pi. Okay, so what will be the result? Okay. Sine square theta. Sine theta. 0 to pi. Yan. Saan tayo nagkamali? Sine square theta. Sine square theta. Okay. Sine cube. Tama naman, no? Sine square theta. Sine theta d theta. Ay, teka. Sorry. Naka-ano pala ako. Sorry. Okay, sorry. Naka-degrees pa rin yung calculator, sorry. So, we have 8 pi over 3. Okay? So, I'm getting 8 pi over 3 a sub o. Ayan. So, I have my period, guys, no? So, we have 8 pi over 3 a sub o. Hence, ayan na, no? So, meron na tayong, ano, guys? Okay, we can now get the d max. Kasi may u max tayo kanina. Okay, so what will be the value of the d max? Okay, so we have 4 pi. Okay, yung u max natin is a sub o from kanina over period, which is 8 pi over 3. 8 pi over 3. So, what will be the value of d max, guys? Okay, what is the maximum directivity for a infinitesimal linear dipole? So, we have, okay, ano pong makukuha? We have 1.5. So, d max would be 1.5. Okay? Okay, so we have 1.5. So very good everyone, no? Option B is the answer. So we have 1.5. Okay? Ayan, no? So now guys, okay, standard results na to, no? So ito kasi dinerive natin, pero usually hindi naman natatanong yung mga hindi naman ano nagpapa-derive ng ganyan sa board exam. So we need to ano, no? Yan, pinakita ko lang just in case, no? Pero may mga standard results na tayo. Okay, tatandaan niyo lang 'tong mga standard results natin. Okay, ano yung mga directivity? So first is we have the ang infinitesimal linear dipole, ang tawag natin diyan is the Hertzian dipole. That's the Hertzian dipole. Sometimes called as elementary doublet. No? So elementary doublet, another term for the Hertzian dipole. Okay? So for the elementary doublet or the Hertzian dipole, so yung maximum directivity natin, Dmax, okay, is equal sa 1.5. Okay? So for Hertz antenna, okay, magkaiba yan, ha? Magkaiba yung Hertz yan sa Hertz, ha? Hertz lang. So for the Hertz antenna or Hertz dipole sometimes, so another term ng Hertz antenna is the lambda over 2 half wave dipole. Okay, yung kanyang maximum directivity is 1.64. Okay? Directivity is 1.64. Okay, guys? Alright. Ayan, no? Tapos, although ito hindi madalas, pero just in case na matanong, we have the monopole also. And we have the Hertzian monopole. And yan, the Marconi antenna. Okay? So, Hertzian monopole. Yan, Hertzian monopole, guys. So, yung Dmax natin is 3. And the Marconi antenna, although again, dito madalas. So, ang Dmax ay 3.28. Okay. So, times 2, no? Nung Hertzian dipole at Hertz antenna. Okay, guys? Ayan. Pero ang madalas na natatanong, guys, is the Hertzian dipole or the elementary doublet and the Hertz antenna or the half-wave dipole. So, 1.5 and 1.64. Okay, guys? Okay. Sige. So, ngayon guys, okay, we also have what we call as the radiation resistance. So, next topic natin to, no? So, we have the radiation resistance. So, what is radiation resistance, guys? Okay, when we say radiation resistance, this refers to the fictitious resistance that represents the element that dissipates the radiation of the antenna. So, kumbaga guys, di ba, you have your antenna. So, let's say ito yung antenna natin. And so this is your antenna. So let's say we have the dipole antenna. Yan yung antenna natin. So ngayon yung antenna natin, ang ina-assume natin guys, okay, may fictitious guys na resistance na nakakabit sa kanya. Okay, kung saan no, yung power radiated natin ay makukompute natin. So kumbaga dito tayo, ano no, so may P-rad siya, no? Yeah, no? So, ang tawag natin dito is the RRAD or the, ano guys, the radiation resistance. Wala talaga yan, ha? Wala pong resistor na nakakabit sa antena nyo. Pero syempre, dahil may niraradiate kang power, and the power will be, appear on a resistor. So, ang formula natin is yan nga, no? So, 1/2 IO R square RAD. Okay. In some books, guys, ang makikita nyong formula niya, parang ano lang, no? Kumbaga, ang formula nito, I lang. Okay, I square. Sorry, but nandito yung square. Sorry. It's supposed to be in the current, ha? Wait lang. Let me erase, guys. Napunta doon yung square, no? Dapat nandito. Yan. So, yung iba makikita nyo, minsan wala pong 1/2. I square lang. Kapag I lang, ang assumption nun, naka-RMS. Ha? Naka-RMS po yan. RMS. Okay? Ito kasi magnitude. Kaya may 1/2. Okay? So ngayon, iba't ibang formula ang radiation resistance for different fundamental antenna types. For Hertz and dipole, ito yung formula natin. For half-wave dipole, guys, dahil fixed na one half wavelength siya, so fixed din yung kanyang ano, guys, radiation resistance, 73 ohms. Okay, 73 ohms. Very popular, very important. Hindi yan na yung binibigay, no? Okay, sa board exam, di na binibigay yan. So, dapat alam nyo na ang radiation resistance no, ng half-wave dipole ay 73 ohms. Now, again, hindi to madalas, pero if ever na matanong yung Hertzian monopole, so this is kalahati ng Hertzian dipole. And the Marconi antenna, as you can see, kalahati rin, no? Ng ano? Kalahati rin siya nung radiation resistance ng half-wave dipole. Okay? And because the length of ano, the length of the Marconi antenna is lambda over 4. So lambda over 4 no, ang length ng Marconi antenna. So because this is a monopole, okay, Marconi antenna is monopole. So ang idea ng Marconi antenna guys is 'di ba half wave dipole dapat lambda over 2. So ito lambda over ano lang, lambda over 4 lang. Okay na, ayan, this is simply lambda over 4. So, but ano no, sa electromagnetics, we have the method of images. So, bali parang, it also functions as a half-wave dipole. Pero yung actual length niya is simply a monopole. Gets? So, this is lambda over 4 also. Ha? So, this is lambda over 4 also. So, kung mayroon kang dalawang lambda over 4, it functions like a dipole. No? So, lambda over 2 pa din siya. Okay? Yan. It function, yan. Ano siya, meron siyang mirror image, no? Okay, mayroon siyang mirror image. Okay? But the actual length, lambda over 4 lang. Okay? Nakatayo siya sa plane conducting ground. So, this is a plane conducting ground, guys. So, this is a plane conducting ground. Okay? Tapos, ayan, bali, nagkakaroon ng mirror image, no? So, mukha siyang dipole pa din. Lambda over 2 pa din yung length niya. Pero lambda over 4 lang talaga siya. Okay? So, I hope that's clear. Okay, sige. So, let's answer number 7, guys. An antenna can be modeled as an electric dipole of length 4 meters at 3 megahertz. Calculates its radiation resistance if the current is uniform over its length. Okay? Anong klaseng, anong klaseng dipole to, no? So, solve natin. What will be the solution? What type of dipole is this, guys? Okay, what type of dipole po ito? Okay? So, first is, let's calculate the wavelength first. Anong formula ng wavelength? C over F. So, 3 times 10 to the 8, it operates at 4 megahertz, guys. Okay, ay 3 megahertz pala. So, 3 times 10 to the 6. Okay, so what's that? How much yung length natin? So, we have 3 times 10 to the 8 over 3 times 10 to the 6. Okay, so we have 100 meters. 100 meters at its length. Okay, so yung length ng antenna natin, sabi rito, is ano, simply 4 meters. 4 meters, guys. So, ito yung ano natin, ha? Ito yung ano natin. Since the length of antenna is less than lambda over 10. Okay, because lambda over 10 is 100 over 10, which is 4, which is 10. Diba? 10 meters yung lambda over 10. Less than sa kanya yung, ano, no? 4. So, we can say that this is, ano, no? Hertzian monopole. Yan. Hertzian monopole siya. So, again, ha, kung less than or equal sa lambda over 10, guys, we can classify it to be an Hertzian monopole. Okay? Hertzian monopole siya. So, ngayon, kung Hertzian monopole siya, ano ang formula sa calculation ng radiation resistance? So, the radiation resistance is simply equal sa 80 pi square, okay, multiplied by the length, ano yung length natin, 4 meters, over the wavelength na 100 whole square. Okay? So, we have 80 pi square times quantity, 4 over 100 square po natin. So, yan, approximately, no, what will be the radiation resistance? So, that is 1.263 ohms. 1.263 ohms. Okay? So, the answer is option B. Option B is the answer. Okay? Clear po? Naintindihan, guys? Everyone, yes, yes, very good, no? Very good, everyone. So, ganun lang. Okay? Now, sir, paano pagka hindi siya, ano, no, less than lambda over 10? So, you cannot consider it as an Hertzian monopole. Kaya lang, pagka ganun, guys, ano, no, empirical na yung magiging result and it's not the scope anymore, no, nung ating, ano, no, nung ating lesson. Okay? So, bali, ano lang siya, no? So, kapag, in the context of board exam, guys, it's either less than or equal sa lambda over 10, okay? Or, ano siya? Lambda over 2 or lambda over 4 siya. So, yun yung mga titignan nyo, no? Lambda over 4, lambda over 2, or less than lambda over 10. Or less than lambda over 10. Okay? Clear? Okay. Ganyan siya, ha? Let's try number 8, guys. So, a dipole with a length of 1.5 meter operates at 100 megahertz while the other has a length of 15 meters and operates at 10 megahertz. The dipoles are fed with the same current. The power radiated by the two antennas will be. Okay, so what will be the solution, guys? So, let us solve first. Okay, ano muna yung, ano, no? Consider muna natin yung unang antenna. So, yung unang antenna daw, guys, okay, no? So, yung length ng unang antenna, L1. So, yung L1 natin ay equal sa, sabi rito, 1.5 meters. Okay, and then, ano yung unang wavelength? So, yung unang wavelength, okay, C over F. So, we have 3 times 10 to the 8. Okay, it operates daw at 100 megahertz po. So, 100 times 10 to the 6. So, 100 times 10 to the 6. So, that is, what's this? 3,000 over 1,000. So, that is 3 meters. Isn't it? So, if sabihin nyo, length L1 natin, okay, tama ba? Tinan nyo. So, if lambda 1 is 3 meters, L1 is basically 1.5 meters. So, tama ba na yung 1.5 is lambda over 2? Lambda 1 over 2. Because this is 3 meters divided by 2, 1.5 meters. Okay, so yung unang antenna mo is lambda over 2. So yung first antenna natin is lambda over 2. So kung lambda over 2 siya, no, ano ang radiation resistance natin? Yan, no? So hence, what will be the P-rad, guys? So yung P-rad ng una, okay, P-rad 1, is equal sa 1/2, okay, IO na lang, square, times 73. Okay? So, 36.5 IO square. Yan yung una. So now, let's proceed, no? So, yung next natin is the other has a length of 15 meters but it operates at 15 megahertz. So, i-consider naman natin yung next na antenna, yung antenna 2. Okay? Kakalculate din natin yung radiated power niya. Consider natin antenna 2, guys. So, yung length ng antenna 2, L2, sabi rito is 15 meters. So, that is 15 meters, right? 15 meters. Okay? Yung wavelength ng pangalawa is equal sa 3 times 10 to the 8, okay, over ano yung frequency, operating frequency ng pangalawa. So, the second operating frequency is 10 megahertz, no? So, 10 times 10 to the 6. Okay, so that is, bali parang 30 over 10. So, 3 din, di ba? Ay, hindi, 30. 300 over 10. Tama? Okay, 30 nga. So, 30 meters. So, hence, okay, ano yung antenna natin, no? So, tama ba na yung L2 natin is simply equal sa lambda over 2 also? Okay, lambda over 2. Half-wave dipole din siya. Okay? Because 30 over 2 is 15. So, ibig sabihin, guys, no, ano yung radiation resistance niya? So, yung Rad natin, okay, is also equal sa, ano, 73 ohms. Oh, so, what will be our P-rad 2? So, yung P-rad 2 natin is 1/2 IO square din. Yan, because they are supplied with the same current. Okay, times 73. So, ang makukuha natin is also 36.5 I O square. So, what can we say? Okay, what is the conclusion, guys? Okay, what is the conclusion? So, the conclusion is that both the antennas will radiate the same power. Okay, correct? Correct, guys? Yes, yes. So, both the antennas will radiate the same power. Yan. Because parehas silang lambda over 2. Dahil parehas silang lambda over 2, no, independent ng independent. They have the same radiation resistance, so parehas lang. Okay. Okay, now guys, let's talk about the antenna efficiency. So kung meron tayong radiation resistance, we also have what we call as the loss resistance. Okay? So pwede yung loss resistance natin is because of the different losses no sa antenna. Skin depth, skin effect, and any other losses. Okay? So meaning to say guys no that the antenna is not 100% efficient. So yung input power natin, it's not equivalent to the radiated power. So nag-input tayo sa antenna, right? May power input tayo. Hindi 'yun equal sa power radiated. So actually ito yung formula natin, no? So yung antenna efficiency, sometimes called as the antenna radiation efficiency. Okay? So antenna radiation and efficiency. Okay, the antenna radiation efficiency. So, this is equal sa radiation resistance over the loss resistance plus the radiation resistance. Now, we can also think of it in terms ng power because sabi nga natin, same yung current niya. So, multiply natin by IO square over IO square, 1/2 nun. So, we'll be getting P rad over P loss plus P rad. Now, guys, this one is the input power. Okay, ito yung input power natin. So in other words, guys, no, this is can also be written as, this is important, no, we will use this later. We will use this result later, pakitandaan po ito. So, ang efficiency natin is the radiated power over the input power. Okay? So another equation, no, with regards to the antenna efficiency. Okay? Sige, solve tayo ng question, guys. Okay, lambda over 2 dipole antenna has a loss resistance of 5 ohms. Calculate the antenna radiation efficiency. So, come on guys, let us solve this. What will be the solution? Ano yung magiging solution natin, guys? Okay, anong formula ng radiation resistance? So, I mean radiation resistance, yung ating antenna efficiency. So, antenna efficiency. Okay, lagyan natin ng A, no, para hindi kayo malito with regards sa, kasi ito rin yung symbol ng no, symbol ng intrinsic characteristic impedance. So, lagyan ko na lang ng A, no, ibig sabihin antenna efficiency siya. So, ang formula niya is the radiation resistance. Kapag lambda over 2 dipole, ang radiation resistance niya fixed na 70, okay, fixed na 73 ohms. Okay, divided by 73 plus 5 ohms na loss resistance. Okay, so we have 93.57%. Okay, option D is the answer, no? So very good, guys. 93.6%. So, nakuha? So, fix kasi yun, ha? Yeah. Now, pag hindi po lambda over 2 dipole yung given, so gamitin nyo yung corresponding formula for the radiation. Okay. Antenna radiation efficiency. Ayan. Ito na. So, let's talk about the antenna gain. So, antenna gain, guys, no? As you can read the definition, it is actually similar or the same with the directive gain. The antenna gain refers to the ratio of the intensity in a given direction to the radiation intensity that will be obtained if the power accepted by the antenna were radiated isotropically. When we say isotropically, it's all over the direction. So, anong pinagkaiba niya sa directive gain? So, ang reference natin is power accepted. Power accepted. In other words, power input. Okay, guys. Kaya, yung formula ng Gmax Instead na Dmax, 'di ba kanina Dmax? Ano yung formula ng Dmax kanina? So sulat ko lang ha. So yung Dmax natin is equal sa 4 pi okay, Umax. Okay, all over Prad. 'Di ba? Ito yung formula kanina ng ano no, maximum directivity or the maximum directive gain. Pero pag antenna gain, ang denominator mo no, instead na Pin, instead na Prad ay Pin. Correct? Nakita niyo yung difference ng dalawa? The formula is the same, the definition is almost the same, the denominator is different. Ang reference natin no for the directivity is the radiation power, power radiated. Ito naman, power input. Now, anong relation ng dalawa, guys? What is the relation of the two? Okay? The antenna radiation efficiency, okay, relates the two, right? Antenna efficiency. So, alam natin na the antenna efficiency, okay, is simply equal, guys, saan? Antenna efficiency is simply equal sa ratio ng radiated power sa input power. So, this is the radiated power, okay, over the input power. So, in other words, guys, no, we can write this as, okay, we have 4 pi, Umax, okay, yung Pin, guys, is what? Tama ba? Yung PE natin ay equal sa Prad okay, over the efficiency. Isn't it? Tama. Oh. Eh di ba kapag ka denominator, pwede mo siyang i-plif. So this would be equal sa efficiency 4 pi Umax over Prad. Okay? But what is this, guys? What is this? Okay, this is Dmax, right? Yan. So, hence, yan, ito yung result natin. So, yung result natin is the antenna gain. The maximum antenna gain is simply equal sa antenna efficiency multiplied by the maximum directivity. Okay? So, nagets guys? So, yun yung relationship, no? So, kumbaga, if consider natin efficiency, so it's actually equal lang sa maximum directivity. So, yun yung antenna gain. Okay? So, I hope that's clear, ha, everyone? Ayan, no? So, based sa mga derivations na ginawa natin. Okay, let's answer a question, guys. Number 10. An antenna has a radiation resistance of 72 ohms and a loss resistance of 8 ohms. If the antenna gain is 12 decibel, calculate its directive gain. Alright. Okay, what will be the solution, guys? What will be the solution? First is, ano munang mahanap natin? Kasi ang given is the antenna gain. Okay, hinahanap is yung directive gain. So, to solve that, we need to get the antenna efficiency first. So, what is the antenna efficiency, guys? Antenna efficiency is equal sa 72 over 72 plus 8. 72 plus 8. So, ilan yan, guys, no? So, what is 72 over 72 plus 8? Okay, so that is 90%, no? So, 90%. 0.9. So, 90%. Okay, hence, yan. Alam natin na yung formula na derived kanina, gain, maximum gain equals antenna efficiency multiplied by Dmax. Multiplied by Dmax. Okay, so Gmax is 12 decibel. So that is 10 raised to 1.2, right? 10 raised to 1.2 equals 0.9 okay, multiplied by Dmax. Okay, so what is Dmax? Bali, 10 raised to 1.2 over 0.9. So, I'm getting 17.6. I'm getting 17.6. Yan. Sir, saan po nang galing to? Sa 12 decibel, guys. Kapag ibabalik mo sa number yung 12 decibel, ganun yung ginagawa, ha? So, 12 dB. Hindi siya equal actually. Okay? So, yung 12 dB in decibel ay equal sa 10 raised to 1.2 in absolute. Okay, so this is absolute measurement. Absolute scale. This is the dB scale. So, bali, ano lang, 10 raised to, divide nyo lang by 10. Diba, 12, divide nyo lang by 10, 1.2. 10 raised to something, no? So, 10 raised to that, that is the absolute. Okay? So, very good everyone, guys. Option C is the correct answer. Okay? Alright. So, let's answer number 11, guys. So, the field strength at the receiving antenna location at the distance 28 kilometers from a half-wave dipole. Ayan. Half-wave dipole daw, no? So, calculate its... hinahanap yung field strength. Okay. So, what will be the solution, guys? Ngayon, pag walang sinabi sa problem, ang assumption natin is that the efficiency is equal sa 1. Okay? So, if no given, if not stated, or it can't be solved, kagaya nung kanina, so if not stated, the antenna efficiency is equal sa 1, and if that's the case, the implication is that the gain, okay, Gmax is equal sa Dmax. So, nagets guys? So, pag hindi sinabi, no, yung assumption natin is that antenna efficiency is equal sa 1 and the gain max, gain antenna gain is equal sa directivity. Okay? So, anong formula ba ng antenna gain? Gmax. Okay? I mean... they actually, ano eh, no? Oh, hindi naman pala gagamitin in this problem, guys. Sorry, no? Hindi naman gagamitin, pero tandaan nyo na lang, ha? Okay? Directivity pala yung hinahanap dito. Okay? Pero hindi natin gagamitin to, ha? Directivity pala yung hinahanap dito, guys. Sorry. So, bali, Dmax ang gagamitin. So, Dmax is equal sa 4 pi. Okay, 4 pi. Umax over period. Okay? Which is equivalent sa 4 pi r square over period. Okay, tapos ito ay ano yung WAB. So bali Dmax is equal sa 4 pi okay, r square e square over 2 eta and all over period. So, hindi naman siya isotropic. Yes, yes. Kaya lang, okay, no? We consider the Dmax here. Ano ang Dmax kapag half-wave dipole? What is the Dmax pag half-wave dipole, guys? And ano ang Dmax natin pag half-wave dipole? So, the Dmax for half-wave dipole is what? Anong value yung lalagay natin dito? 1.64. Equal siya sa 4 pi. Okay, yung R natin is 28 kilometers. So, 28 times 10 to the 3. Square. Multiplied by electric field, di natin alam. Square. Over 2 times 120 pi. All over 0.1 kilowatt. So, 100 watts. And let's solve for E. So, anong magiging value ng E, guys? Okay, so I'm getting 3.54 millivolts per meter. Okay guys, so option C is the answer. So, nagets po. So, naiintindihan guys? Alright. So, Problem number 12, this would be your homework. Okay, this would be your homework, guys. Again, ha, to mark your attendance in the session, guys, like the session, as well as ano, comment your answers no for the homework problem. So, basahin natin yung homework problem, guys. So, determine the magnitude of the electric field intensity at a distance of 10 kilometers for an antenna having a directive gain of 5 dB and radiating a total power of 20 kilowatts. Assume free space. Round your answer into 3 decimal places. Okay? So, again, ha, yung same lang to halos ng solution natin kanina. Okay, same lang halos ng solution natin kanina. Anyway, the answer here, yan, pakisagutan, no? And i-comment dun sa video once this becomes available after the session. Also, no, yung password natin for today's PDF, guys, would be what? Yan. And no question mark, no, just what? What? Yan. Okay, sige guys, no? Yan. Alright? So, clear? Okay, sige. So, let's answer, no, problem number 13. So, a certain antenna has a radiation efficiency of 95% and a maximum radiation intensity of 0.5 watts per steradian. So, calculate its directivity, okay, when the input power is 0.4 watt. So, when we say directivity, guys, sabi ko nga, no, sometimes it is used interchangeably with the Dmax. So, this is the Dmax. Okay, directive gain, directivity, no? So, Dmax yung hinahanap natin. Okay, Dmax yung hinahanap sa atin. Okay, so, ngayon, as you can see, no, input power tayo. Input power tayo, guys. So, dahil input power yan, anong formula ang gagamitin natin for the solution? So, kasi kung radiated power, yung parang formula lang kanina. Pero since this is, ano, no, we are dealing with input power, so what will be the solution? Ang gagamitin natin is yung gain. Okay? So, yung Gmax. So, yung Gmax, which is equal sa 4 pi. Okay? 4 pi. Okay? Umax. All over. Okay? Isa na P rad P in. Tama? But the Gmax, alam natin yung formula ng Gmax is what? Antenna efficiency. Okay, multiplied by the Dmax, 'di ba? That's the formula that we use here. Okay, equal sa 4 pi okay, Umax all over P in. All over P in. Okay, so let's solve. Let's solve, guys. Okay, ano yung efficiency? 95%. So, we have 0.95. Okay, we are asked to solve for the directivity, so Dmax. Okay, equals 4 pi. Okay, what is the Umax, guys? Sabi sa problem, ang Umax is what? Okay, 0.5 watts per steradian. Okay, over, okay, power input na, 0.4. Okay, so solve, let us solve for the Dmax. Okay, so we obtained 16.53. So, Dmax is 16.53. And we have 16.53. Okay, very good everyone. Option B is the correct answer. Josephine, very good. Jericho, Jomel, okay, Jay, everyone, very good. Option B is the answer, 16.53. So, nagets guys? Very easy, right? Okay, so, kaya lang, dami lang talagang formula, no? So, they are connected with each other. Okay, sige. So, some other definitions, guys. No, so, let's go to them one by one. First is polarization, no? So, ano yung polarization, guys? Polarization, this refers to the orientation or direction no ng electric field vector in space, no? So na-discuss na natin to dun sa uniform plane waves, guys. And I also mentioned yung relevance niya no sa antenna. So anong relevance ng polarization no with the context ng antenna? So ang relevance ng polarization, guys, is that the polarization of your antenna should be the same no as the ano radio wave, no, para ma-receive niya. Okay, dapat parehas sila. Now, we have here the end effect. Ano yung end effect? So, when we are considering the actual physical length of the antenna, guys, okay, it is actually, sabi rito, 5% shorter. So, bali may equation tayo rito na mabubuo, guys. No, yung actual length natin, considering the end effect. Okay? So, if we gonna consider the end effect, guys, no, so yung actual length ng antenna natin, when we are considering the end effect, is simply equal sa, ano, 0.95, no, nung kanyang length na nasolve. Kasi it is 5% shorter, no, because of the end effect. And by default, guys, hindi siya sinasama, no? We need, it needs to be mentioned in the problem bago nyo gagamitin yung formula. Okay? And last is the front to back ratio. Kung maaalala nyo yung ano natin, guys, no? Kung maaalala nyo yung ating radiation pattern. So, let's say, guys, that this is our radiation pattern, guys. Yan. So, diba, sa favored direction natin, mataas yung ano natin, no? Mataas yung ating power. I mean, yung ating radiation intensity, it is high. Pero sa opposite direction, mababa, right? So, kukunin natin yung ratio nun, no? Yung intensity dito, saka intensity dito, sa kabilang side. Pag kinuha nyo yung ratio nun, that is called, that is what we call as the front-to-back ratio. Okay? So, this refers to the ratio of the power radiated in the favored direction of an antenna over the power radiated in the opposite direction. Okay. So, let's try to answer a problem here. Calculate the length of a half-wave dipole for an operating frequency of 200 MHz considering an effect. Okay? Considering an effect, what will be our solution? What will be our solution? Okay. Sige, guys. Okay, solve po natin. Alright. Okay. Sige. Okay. Yan. So, what will be the formula, no? A half-wave dipole siya. So, the length, okay, ng half-wave dipole is lambda over 2, no? Kaya nga half-wave dipole, eh, no? Lambda over 2. Fix yung length niya. So, we have 3 times 10 to the 8. Okay, over. Okay, ano yung frequency natin? 200 MHz. 200 times 10 to the 6. Okay, all over 2. So, what do we get, guys? What do we get? So, we have 3 times 10 to the 8 over 200 MHz over 2. So, we have, ano po? Okay, 0.75 meters. Kaya lang, guys, according sa problem, sabi rito, considering an effect. So, what will be the actual length, guys? Sabi natin, no, the actual length is 5% shorter. So, you just need to multiply by 0.95. So, 0.95 times 0.75 meter. So, anong makukuha natin? What is the actual length, guys? So, the actual length is 0.95 times 0.75. So, we have 0.7125. So, the correct answer is option B. Option B. Clifford, very good, no? Lois, very good. Eliza, Crystalline, everyone, very good. Okay? So, naiintindihan po. Nagets, guys? Alright. Let's proceed, no? Okay, next. Capture area. So, ito is more on the receiver side. Okay? More on the receiver side, guys. So, this refers to the effective area, okay, or capture area. Okay, no? So, area effective, minsan ginagamit natin yung word na ACAP, okay, to say that this is the capture area, okay, upon which the antenna, okay, collects electromagnetic energy from the incident wave. So, it's more on a receiver parameter, guys, okay, more on a receiver parameter. So, ang formula natin is lambda square over 4 phi, efficiency times the Dmax. Yan, so alam natin na this is antenna gain, right? So, G, we can use the word G. And sometimes, we just use the word R to indicate na this happens if the antenna acts as a receiving antenna. Okay, so GR. So, in other words, no, another formula that we can have here is the effective area is equal sa lambda square, okay, over 4 pi times the gain ng receiving antenna. gain ng receiving antenna. Okay? Alright. So, game. Let's do this. So, determine the maximum capture area of an antenna operating at 950 MHz if its maximum directivity is 1.5. So, dito natin gagamitin yung mention ko kanina, no? So, pag not stated, okay, dahil not stated siya, what is the efficiency, guys? So, kung not stated siya, the efficiency, ang assumption natin dito ay 1. Okay, efficiency is 1. Okay, so what will be the area effective? Okay, the effective area or the capture area. So first, let us get the wavelength first. 3 times 10 to the 8 over, okay, 950 MHz. So 950 times 10 to the 6. Okay, quantity square all over 4 pi, all over 4 pi, multiplied by the gain. Okay, so... Okay, no? So, hindi ko nalagay yung type ng antenna. Sorry. So, this is what? Anong type ng... sorry. Ito pala. Hindi na pala kailangan. Sorry. Yan. Hindi na pala kailangan ng type antenna. Sorry. Hindi ko nabasa. May yung ito, no? Maximum directivity is 1.5. So, this is, Hertzian dipole, right? Maximum directivity is 1.5, eh. So, 1 because the efficiency is 1. And then, we have 1.5 here. Okay? So, what will be the answer, guys? So, we have 3 to the 8 over 950 to the 6. Number 4 pi times 1.5. So, we will be getting what? We'll be getting, yan. Effective area is what? We have 0.0119 square meters. Or, naka-centimeter square yung mga answers. So, multiply natin by 100 centimeters, 1 meter square. Okay, 119. Yan, option A is the answer. Okay, option A is the answer. Okay, clear? Clear, everyone? Yes, yes. Okay. So, now let's talk about some basic antenna types, okay, other than the fundamental antenna types. So, ito yung mga antenna na hindi fundamental but is appearing, no, in the board exam. So, the first one is the horn antenna. So, ito yung shape niya, no? Ito yung itsura niya in real life. So, usually, no, ang binibigay na equation is the gain and the beam width, okay? Kaya lang, this is aperture type, no? So, dalawa yung dimension niya. So, yung isa is the E-plane dimension, so DE. Okay? And then, we have the... Okay, DH here. Yan. So, dahil dalawa yung dimension niya, dalawa din yung beamwidth niya. We have the E-plane beamwidth and the H-plane beamwidth. Okay? We also have the gain. So, ito yung equation ng gain. 7.5 DEDH over lambda square. So, it's more on formula-based, guys, no? Yan. Gain and beamwidth, tatandaan, no? Pagdating sa various types ng antenna. So, we have the horn antenna here. Now, we also have the parabolic antenna. This is the most popular antenna, no? Especially in doing microwave communications. Okay? So, parabolic antenna, it is a form of a dish antenna with a reflecting surface that is geometric paraboloid. So, it has a focal point where rays arriving parallel to antenna axis converge. Okay? So, dalawa din equation niya, isa sa gain, isa sa beam width. Kaya lang dito, guys, no, hindi po 1 yung efficiency niya. So, ang efficiency niya, ang assumption natin is, this is from what? So, what will be the value of the efficiency pagdating sa parabolic antenna? So, efficiency niya, that is 0.5. Okay, 55 to 0.7. If not stated, we use 0.6. And if not stated. Okay, clear? Yan. And also the beamwidth is also, given, 70 lambda over D. So, yung D is the diameter, guys. diameter nung okay, helical antenna. Ayan. So helical antenna, as you can see, no, the shape is in helix. Okay? So this antenna, this is circularly polarized. Okay? This is a circularly polarized antenna. So usually, no, ginagamit natin to for ano, no, satellite communication, no? So from Earth station, guys, kung magpapadala ka ng signal sa satellite, ang kailangan na gagamitin is helical antenna, because when your signal passes, no, some layers of the ionosphere, what happens is it will become circularly polarized. So ibig sabihin, guys, no, dapat yung antenna na gagamitin ay circularly polarized din, no, to be able to send and receive signals. Okay? So ito yung formula natin, guys, no? So 15 ns pi d square over lambda cube. So nakakatakot yung equation, guys, no? And the bandwidth is 52 lambda over pi d square root of lambda over ns. So sir, ano yung n? N is number of turns, guys, as you can see, no? Number of turns. So umiikot siya. So yung s natin, no? Yung s natin, ang tawag dun ay pitch. Okay? S is the pitch. So ano yung pitch, sir? Diameter nung pag-ikot. Okay? Kasi yung diameter nung antenna, yung diameter mismo nung conductor. When we say pitch, guys, 'di ba? Ano siya, no? Helical yung shape niya. So may diameter siya, may diameter 'to na parang ganoon, no? Yan. So ito yung S natin. Okay? 'Di ba? Kasi umiikot siya, eh. Yung diameter nung mismo nung nung helix. Kasi yung diameter na 'di yung diameter nung conductor mismo. Now, optimum value. Sometimes, guys, hindi siya given, so we will use the optimum values. Okay, pag hindi given, ha? So we will use the optimum values. So what are the optimum values? So for the D, this is simply equal sa lambda over pi. Okay? For S, this is equal sa lambda over 4. Sometimes not given kasi. Okay? Sometimes they are not given. So we will use the optimum values, lambda over pi and lambda over d. Okay. And of course, guys, no? Yan, although wala na masyado to ngayon, no, so we have the rhombic antenna. So nakita niyo itsura niya. So parang ano, no, parang mga poste, napakalaki niya. Okay? So ito 'yon, yung mismo itong whole structure na to, ito yung rhombic antenna, guys. So yung rhombus na 'yan. Ayun yung whole structure na ito. Ito yung tinatawag nating rhombic antenna, guys. Yeah, this whole structure here. So that is the rhombic antenna. So very popular lang siya in the context ng board exam because this is the only non-resonant antenna, no? Non-resonant horizontally polarized antenna. Okay, having four conductors forming a diamond or rhombus, usually fed at one apex and terminated with resistance or impedance at the opposite apex. Okay? Yan. So parang ano, no? Laki niya, di ba? So that is a rhombic antenna. So automatic, no, when we say non-resonant antenna, yan, that is the first thing that needs to come in your mind. So we have the rhombic antenna. So that is a non-resonant antenna. So let us solve problems, no, in relation dun sa mga formula na binigay ko sa inyo kanina, no, para makapag-practice tayo, guys. Okay, number 16. So an elementary doublet is capable. When we say elementary doublet, this is Hertzian dipole, guys. Okay, again, another term for the elementary doublet is the Hertzian dipole. And so this is the Hertzian dipole. Okay, it's capable of radiating at an input of 1 kilowatt. So if you are to replace this with a rhombic antenna, so papalitan doon natin siya ng rhombic antenna instead of elementary doublet, what should its gain in decibel to be able to radiate the same field strength daw, okay, at the same distance with half the input power. Okay, so paano gagawin dito, sir? So ang gagawin natin, no, so again, ha, wala sinabi about the efficiency. Okay, wala sinabi sa efficiency. So ibig sabihin, no, ang assumption natin, guys, is that the efficiency is 1. Okay? Yung efficiency na 0.6 lang tayo, guys, is for the parabolic antenna. But in anything else, assumption natin is 1. Alright? Okay. So, dahil walang sinabi, we can assume that, okay, yung Gmax natin, okay, Gmax natin is equal sa Dmax, no? Okay, anong formula nun? We have 4 pi. Okay, 4 pi r square. Okay, e square over 2 eta. Yan. Yung eta na intrinsic characteristic impedance, no? Over P in. Yan, no? So, dinerive ko na yan galing dun sa, ano, no? Kasi, di ba, ano talaga yung formula na formula ng Gmax? Formula ng Gmax ay 4 pi, okay, U max all over P rad. Okay? Over P in, no? Because this is gain. So, from there, ito na yung nakuha, ha? Ito na yung naging result. Okay. Anyway, so, okay guys, so sabi daw, for elementary doublet po, okay, is capable of radiating at an input of 1 kilowatt. So, 1 kilowatt siya. So, bale, field strength. No? So, ito kasi yung mga values na, because everything else is considered constant na. Right? Naintindihan ba? Constant na lahat eh. Kasi tinan nyo ha. Same distance. Okay, kaya R square parehas lang. Of course, intrinsic characteristic impedance, 125 parehas yun. So, ibig sabihin yung mga variables na lang dito is yung Gmax, yung P in, tsaka, okay, same field strength din, di ba? Sabi sa problem, same field strength. Okay, if, ayan, an elementary doublet is capable of radiating at an input of 1 kilowatt. If you are to replace this with a rhombic antenna, what should its gain be, no, to be able to radiate the same field strength? So, constant din yung field strength. Okay, so in other words, guys, no, ang gagawin nyo na lang is simply, okay, Gmax. So, Gmax times P in is equal sa, ano guys? Is equal siya sa 4 pi R square E square over 2 eta. So, all of these are constant. Constants yan. So, sir, ano yung kung constant? Kung constant, guys, okay, dun sa second iteration natin, we can just equate. Gets po? Constant yan eh. Sabi sa problem. Sir, bakit po constant? Kasi same distance, same field strength. Mm. So, ibig sabihin, kung gagawin natin 1, 2, kumbaga G, okay, G1, P1 ay equal sa G2, P2. Okay? Dahil efficiency is 100%, this can be D1, P1 equals D2, P2. Okay? So, ano yung D1? Ano ang gain ng hertz and dipole? 1.5. Okay? Ano yung input power? 1, 1,000. Ano yung pangalawang directivity? Hindi natin alam. Ano yung input power ng pangalawa? 500. No, because half the input power daw. Half the input power daw. Half the input power yung pangalawa. Okay, so what will be the gain or what will be the directivity of the rhombic antenna dito? So this is simply equal sa 1.5 over 2. Okay, 0.75. Ah, 7.5. Tama ba? 3 pala, 3. Okay, 3. Hence, so ano yung gain natin in dB? 10 log ng 3. Okay, so what is 10 log ng 3? So we have 4.77. Okay, so option B, C is the answer. 4.77, option C is the answer. Okay? So, naiintindihan guys? Nagets po ba? Yes? Yes, sir. Okay, next. So, calculate the beam width of a helical antenna, okay, having a diameter of 80 millimeters and a pitch of 62.5 millimeters. The antenna operates at 1.2 gigahertz, okay, where lambda equals 0.2 meter and has 8 turns. So, what will be the solution, guys? Direct substitution lang sa formula. Direct substitution lang sa formula. Okay, ano yung formula natin guys no ng beamwidth po ng helical antenna? The beamwidth is 52 okay, lambda over pi d. Okay, square root ng lambda over ns. So we'll not use the optimum values because may mga given na values, no? So we just use them. 52 times 0.25 okay, over pi times d. So pi times, ano yung diameter natin? Sabi sa problem, we have 80 millimeters. It's 10 to the minus 3. Okay, multiplied by root of lambda, 0.25. Number of turns, how many turns do we have? 8 turns. Okay, over times S. S is 62.5. Okay, so let us solve, guys. Okay, so we have 36.57 degrees. And we have 36.57 degrees. Okay, clear? Yes, yes, very good. Option B is the answer. Option B is the answer. Okay. Sige. Okay, gets naman? All right. So, next question, guys. Yan, parabolic. A parabolic antenna has a diameter of 3 meters, efficiency of 60%, and operates at frequency of 4 gigahertz. Calculate its gain in dBi. Saan ano po itong dBi na to? Yung dBi is simply just dB, guys. Pero ang ibig sabihin, reference sa isotropic. So, reference tayo. Reference, okay, natin, reference is isotropic antenna. Okay? So, pakita ko sa inyo kung paano ito ginagawa, ha? I'll show you. So, what will be the solution, guys? First, let us get first the, ano, no? Let us get the gain of the antenna first. Okay, anong formula natin? So, yung formula ng gain is efficiency, okay, times pi d, okay, over lambda whole square. So, 0.6 daw, di ba? So, 0.6, okay, tapos pi, okay, d. What is the diameter, guys? 3 meters. So, 3 meters is the diameter. 3 meters is the diameter. Okay, over the wavelength. So, what is the wavelength, guys? So, 4 gigahertz operating frequency. So, 3 times 10 to the 8 over 4 times 10 to the 9. Okay. Whole square, right? So, what will be the G? Okay, so solve po natin. So, we have 0.6 tapos pi times 3 over 3 to the 8, 4 to the 9 whole square. Okay, we have 9474.82. Yan siya. So, sir, paano po kunin yung gain in dBi? Dalawa kasi yan, guys, no? So, when it comes to the gain, okay, ng antenna na may reference, dalawa yung possible. Okay? Pag sinabi natin gain in dBi, ang reference natin is isotropic. So, gdBi is simply equal dun sa gain na na-compute nyo, 10 log, no? 10 log na ng gain na na-compute nyo, ang gain ng isotropic antenna, guys, is 1. So, G over 1. Naintindihan? So, in this case, we have what? We have 10 log. Okay, 10 log ng, ano yung G natin? Ayan yun, ano yung 9474. 9474, okay, 0.82 divide by 1. Okay? So, ganun, guys. So, what is the G dBi? So, ibig sabihin ng dBi is gain with reference sa isotropic. So, 10 log ng 9474.82 over 1. So, we have 39.77 dBi. Okay, sabi sa problem is round up your answer to the nearest whole number. So, we have 40 dBi, option D. Sir, meron pa bang isa? Okay, meron pang isa, guys, no? Kapag dBd. So, pag dBd yung hinahanap. So, paano ang formula no, ng gain kapag ang reference mo is the dipole, DBD? So, practical antenna to pag DBD, guys. Ang reference ay dipole. So, 10 log ng, okay, gain na given over 1.64. Okay. Ayan. So, usually for practical antennas, ayan yung ginagamit natin. Pag theoretical, DBI. Pagka practical, DBD. So, you just need to look carefully no, kung ano ang magiging reference. Kasi kapag ganyan, yan, 10 log ng G over 1.64. Okay? Clear, everyone? Yes? Yes. Okay. So, number 19, let us solve. Okay, determine the gain of the horn antenna in DBI again. Okay, with the following parameters. Okay, let us solve, no? What will be the solution, guys? What will be the solution? Okay. So, ano yung gain natin in DBI po? Gain in DBI? You know, so it is, diretsuhin ko na, no? 10 log. 10 log ng? Yan. Ano ang formula ng horn antenna, guys? Yan. Over 1 to, no? Reference natin ay 1. Yan. 7.5. Okay. DE. DH. Over. Okay, lambda square. Over lambda square. Okay, so we have 10 log. 7.5. Okay, what is the DE? So, the E plane aperture, 7.5 centimeters. So, 7.5 times 10 to the minus 2. Multiplied by, okay, 2.5. So, we have 2.5 times 10 to the minus 2. Okay, all over. Okay, lambda square. So, 3 times 10 to the 8 over. What is the frequency, guys? 10 gigahertz. So, 10 times 10 to the 9. Okay, whole square. Yan, all over. 1. Oops. Okay, what's the answer, guys? So, come on, help me. Ano ang makukuha? What will be the answer? So, option A, no? 11.938. DBI. So, option A is the answer. Okay, guys? Nagets po? Okay. Sige. Okay. Now guys, okay, we have the last one though. Last question po no for today's set. So this is specifically for antenna system. Okay, for antenna system. So let us read the problem, guys. So an antenna system consisting of a transmitting half-wave dipole antenna does an input power of 10 watts and an elementary doublet on the receiving end which is 40 kilometers away. Determine the captured power, okay? So, another term ng captured power is the received power, guys. Okay. So, received power, another term for this one. Okay. Of the receiving antenna. Assume operating frequency of 950 megahertz. Okay. What will be the solution, guys? So, ito yung mga tanong, no, pag antenna system na yung pinag-uusapan, guys. Actually, ito yung ano eh, di ba? Name nung subject na ito. So, 'di ba, in our university, so this is not called as EMFT, 'di ba? Yung HUL. Ang tawag ay transmission media and antenna systems. So, 'yan, antenna systems, guys. Okay, so sa antenna systems, no, meron tayong tinatawag na captured power equation. So, yung captured power natin, guys, okay, ang formula niya, okay, is actually okay. Gain ng receiving antenna. Okay, I mean gain ng transmitting antenna. Yan. Gain ng transmitting antenna times bale ang mangyayari kasi ano eh no? Tawag dito. Gain ng transmitting antenna times the input power. Okay. Yan. Gain ng transmitting antenna times the input power over 4 pi r square. And so basically, ito yung sa pointing vector, no? So ito yung W av natin. Actually, the magnitude of this one. Okay? Multiplied by the effective area, no? If you can still remember, we have the effective area. You know, so we have the effective area. So anong formula nung effective area, guys? So the effective area is the lambda square and over 4 pi and times the gain of the receiving antenna. So ito yung effective area. Yan. So yan yung equation na ginagamit natin, no, for antenna system problems. Okay. Sige. Game. Yan, no? So walang given na efficiency, guys. So assumption natin yung gain natin is equal sa directivity. So an antenna system consisting of a transmitting half-wave dipole. So anong gain ng half-wave dipole, guys? 1.64. So this is 1.64. And gain ng transmitting antenna yon. Multiplied by the input power. The input power is 10 watts. So this is 10. And divided by 4 pi. Okay, ano yung distance, guys? Gano'ng kalayo siya pinadala? So 40 kilometers. So 40 times 10 to the 3 whole square times the operating frequency, wavelength. I mean, 3 times 10 to the 8 over the operating frequency. Operating frequency is, what's that? 950 megahertz. So, 950 times 10 to the 6, okay, whole square, over 4 pi. Multiplied by the gain of the receiving antenna. The receiving antenna is elementary doublet. Again, walang binigay na efficiency. So, ibig sabihin, equal din siya sa gain ng receiving antenna. We have the directivity 1.5. Okay? Yan, no? So, upon calculation, guys, what is the formula of the receive power? Okay? Or the capture power? Yan, ang dami nagkamali dyan, guys, no, kahit na simple lang siya. So, ingat lang sa calculation, no. Most likely mga ano lang, no. Silly mistakes lang with regards to the calculation yung nangyayari. So, we have 9.71 picowatts. And we have 9.71 picowatts as our answer. Okay, so option A. Yes? Yes. So actually, no, that ends our lecture for today. Alright. Alright. So, okay guys? Ayos ba? Yes? Yes. Eh, no? So, may natutunan ba in today's session? Yes. So, kung meron, guys, no? So, don't forget to like the session, guys, to mark your attendance and also, no, answer the homework problem, no, in the comment section. So, thank you everyone, no, for attending the live session. God bless po. And see you guys, no, sa mga next nating mga lecture, no? So, thank you guys and bye-bye po. Bye, guys. Thank you, thank you. Thank you po.